for the person. Iman can be negative, and Iman can be absolutely useless. And this is all in the Quran, the Book of Allah. I would like to start with the second time, with the fact that Muslims, and I'm talking about Muslims, can be so negative with an Iman. When you have the word of Tawheed in your heart, and you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you believe in His book and His messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but your Iman is so much shrinked to that level that you only care about certain part of the Islam and you neglect most of the part of the Islam, and makes you so much selfish that you only focus on how much I gain hasanat for myself. With the Iman, brothers and sisters, drives Muslim to only focus on the spiritual part and the part of the ibadat, how to worship Allah, how much do I pray every day, how many days do I fast every year, and how much tasbih and dhikr I do every night, how many umrah have I performed in my life. All these things, brothers and sisters, they are really important. They are really part of the Islam, but they are not the whole Islam. The way Muslim at that level acts and reacts to his deen and his iman makes it so negative, because you only focus on how much hasanat you get for yourself. You only focus on yourself. You don't expand your interest outside your own self. That type of iman, brothers and sisters, is so negative, and it doesn't accomplish you much. And there's a hadith within the hadith where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us a very interesting story that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Jibreel, or one of the angels, to take punishment to a village. The all people in that village were so sinful. They haven't done anything good in their life. Of course, the angel obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and rushed to that village. As soon as he arrived, he saw one abid, one worshipper, a person who has never committed a sin toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All his life was spent in ibadah, in worshipping Allah, tasbih, salah, tiyah, everything. Then they came back, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, and Allah knows the best. إِنَّ فِيهَا عَبْدًا وَفُلَانُ. Your slave, your worshipper, Fulan, X, is in that village. He lives there. Then what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and He knows what this person has done, He said, أَلَا بِهِ فَبْدَهُ. Your punishment should start from that person. فَإِنَّهُ لَمْ يَنَّ مَعْعَ وَجْهُهُ فِي يَوْمٍ. His face expressions did not even change, has not even changed to show anger against the sins that his people accomplished and his people committing. أَلَا بِهِ فَبْدَهُ. Start with that negative believer. Start with that negative, useless believer. Why? Because his face, his feelings, his action never reacted to the fact that Allah has been disobeyed outside his house. This type of negativity is not condemned. The third side, or the third part of the Iman, the third category of the Iman, is that Iman, brothers and sisters, can really be useless. Can really be useless, that the people, their level of Iman is so much reluctant, there's so much hesitant to believe or not to believe, to follow Allah or we wait until something happens. Shall we follow Allah or the one who actually in power and he's against the need of Allah? They're always between this and that. Yes, they are munafiqeen, but some of them, they don't really care much about the Iman itself. They get to the point, they will see that the deen of Allah is taking over and say, now we are believer. Allah said that doesn't work. And that is in the Quran. أَلْيَقْرُونَ إِلَّا أَنْ يَأْتِيَ رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَائِكَةَ أَوْ يَأْتِيَ بَعْضُ آيَاتِكَ. الله لا يرضي ربي لا ينفع المال لا ينفع نفس ايمانها لم تكن من قط او كسبت في لن يفعل. That is the part we forget. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the kafirin. That what are they waiting? That they want to see Allah, they want Allah, they want the Lord to come down and they can see Him. They want to see the malaika come and they will look at them, or they want to see signs, really strong signs. When those signs come to them and they have to leave them with no doubt that is la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, at that moment their iman is useless, or their iman they have had before, does it entitle them for any good? That kind of iman that doesn't really move our eyes even one inch to gain one hasad of Allah. It's there, hidden. Iman in the heart, yeah, but it's not enough. If it doesn't move our eyes toward the good, that means the deen of Allah, the good deeds, this iman is absolutely useless. Our hasad of iman in the heart, Allah will not accept that iman. There is useless iman, yes. Iman is important. It might eventually give you the Jannah, but it's useless for this world. And deen is for dunya and akhirah. The deen of Allah was for deen, for this dunya and for akhirah. And of course, the main tie and the name of the most important tie, which really materialized the Islam itself, is the positive iman. Every time iman is mentioned in the Quran, Allah says, "Al-Ladhina amanu salihat." Those who believe and perform good deeds. There's no one iman mentioned without good deeds. Always in the Quran they're what's connected. Good deeds are always connected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot invent all good deeds. You have to know that Allah is pleased with that good deeds. And Allah has determined all what we have to do and what we not to do in this life. Islam, brothers and sisters, is not a religion only. I always say that. Islam is a way of life. Islam is an order. Because if you reverse religion to Arabic, it doesn't mean religion, it means diana. And that applies to everything else, but doesn't apply to Islam. When you say deen in Arabic, and when you really translate it to English, it has to be order. It's an order for life. Because it covers every single aspect of our life, in the political world, in the economical level, in the social level, everywhere. If you practice Islam, you practice Islam. And this will be positivity. Baba! Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتِ النَّاسِ. You mean the best ummah, that this nation was brought out to people. Why, Ya Allah? He said, تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ. Does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teach you? You promote good deeds and forbid bad deeds, and you believe in Allah. Now, the logic of order, it has to be believe, then you do the good deeds. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to make sure that you understand that your iman itself is not enough. It has to be for you to be entitled to be the best among the whole world, is that you do the good deeds and you do the bad deeds. It's so important because in the Quran there's nothing coincidence. When Allah wants something first, Allah means it. And of course, brothers and sisters, also part of the positivity of Islam, that Muslims should not only focus on themselves. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spent his whole life, and the Sahaba after him, they spent their whole lives spreading the deen of Allah, working, they're so much worried about the least of the nations. They were worried about them. Because they didn't want any of their wealth, they didn't want to have them slaves, they didn't want anything. Every nation they approached, they won't come with the justice of Islam. The Muslims should go outside himself and expand his feelings and his thoughts. You care about the rest. You care about yourself, about your family, about your tribe, about your nation, and about the whole world. Islam Sahaba Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you look at them, you think they all belong to one man. They all were born from one man. They act the same way, the one that reached Spain and the one that reached China. They all acted the same way. The same way Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them. So brothers and sisters, your iman should be polarizing you to reach the highest level in dunya and akhirah. You have to come outside your own soul and your own family and worry about everyone else in this world, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you. You're the ummah of risal, you're the ummah of message, carry this message to everyone else. Why? Because you'll be entitled. In the day of judgment, if someone says, Ya Allah, they believe in you, tell me. We are in charge. You will be asked. You will be asked in the day of judgment. And of course, in an occasion like this, we have to eliminate our feeling and see how much great this is that is. You look at your life, you see someone from different continent. You see your life, you see someone from different continent. What put you together is the Islam, and that's what